submarine up in Lake Erie, Cleveland, Ohio. It's a great tour if you're ever in the area. It's real close to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And the point there where you can go out by the water, check it out. I got video topside here of the submarine, and then I also have some down below. It's a pretty long video here, but I'll show you everything below decks as well. And towards the end, I got a short video of Lake Erie and First Energy Stadium and that kind of thing. So I hope you enjoy it. There's no slots in this one, but I'll have some slot videos up real soon. Once again, this is USS COD. I'm an ex-Navy submariner myself here, so I was stationed on a U.S. attack submarine. So I hope you enjoy this. Once again, Richard Bott slots. Thanks. Bye.
USS COD, Cleveland, Ohio, right on Lake Erie. Aft of the USS COD. And the bow. Aft. Walking from aft to the bow, USS COD, trying not to trip and fall in the water. Pretty interesting. Cost you $12 plus parking. I didn't realize you could park right at the USS COD. It saved me $10, but. It's all good. Real windy up here. Lake Erie. Coast Guard. Conning tower. Torpedo and torpedo transport vehicle. And do this without falling in the water. Walking towards the aft, or is this the front? Yeah. Wow. Entrance to the sub. Cleveland. Coast Guard, Lake Erie, Conning Tower, and heading down in. Thank you. Being an ex-submariner, I've seen this view quite a few times. And we're in the sub. Entrance into the torpedo room. And back off my torpedo tube. The torpedo. On top we got used to some berthing racking for ship's crew. Right on top of the torpedoes. Same thing on the other side. Lots of air valves and firing mechanisms. Oh, hi.
That sounds serious. Instead of fishing and dropping it. And it's made out of wood, though. I just rigged up something. I was raring to get down here and see how effective it might be.
Yeah.
And I got another couple.
Yeah, we got it going on.
Now it's looking pretty clean up there compared to how funky it was
before. I'm amazed it's stayed that clean for a stretch of 2 days. Yeah. That's a kind of record.
I was wondering how long it takes for it to get all funky again.
It depends on the wind.
Okay.
We're basically at the mercy of the wind where that all that debris will float.
I saw even people with that floating barge next door. There were some really big monster logs out there that they were trying to get rid of, you know, because it was getting in the way of their operation when they're launching their boat.
Yeah.
That's another bunk up there, but yeah, that hatch there is where the torpedoes were brought down.
Okay.
All muscle power.
That's where they load the
chains and pulleys. That was all muscle and
more berthing, and there's the loading hatch.
I imagine that took a while to restock 16 torpedoes down here.
We loaded ours through the main access hatch. Yes, okay.
I'm still kind of doing it. Sometimes I just, you know, like I said, I'm still learning the boat. And a lot of people, you know, ask a lot of questions, of course. And I'm nowhere near qualified to answer all of them. Trying to learn a little bit at a time, but I just tell them I'm a newbie and still learning the boat.
No, the more you do it, the more you'll pick up.
This picture here.
Fancy restroom right here.
Yeah, that's the officer's head. And this picture here, all the pictures through the boat are not like something they got out of archives or whatever. That photo right there is of that hatch.
Yeah, okay.
One of the stewards climbing through during the war.
Actual photos.
Oh, that even rotates? You can rotate the...
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. I never saw one like that. Oh, okay, so you can view behind yourself, shoot yourself, or over mm-hmm. your shoulder to your rear. Ah, that's a nice unit. You
can do like a selfie if you want to. On board the USS COD.
Fuzzy thing, microphone, so you're recording sound also. It's here. A microphone?
That's a cover for wind.
Yep.
They call it a dead cat.
So, get the wind and stuff.
There we go. It had the, I'll probably talk to you in a little bit here. So.
Fine. Yeah, face the ladder and hold on tight. You got a nice short step there. And then straight down.
Heading aft. to shower. Looks like officers' kitchen, mess deck. It's like officer berthing. Looks like officers' mess. Continuing aft, junior officer quarters. Continuing aft. Might be captain's quarters here, maybe. Probably the only one that gets his own bed, I would think.
Jim, you told me that you can go into submarine now, right? Or,
executive officers.
That's pretty fine. That's, this is where they serve food, right here. Put it right here. This is their shower.
Could be the goat locker. Chiefs. Looks like could be Yeoman. And continuing aft. This must be the control room. Rigged for red. Kind of hard to see, but give it a go. Quite a bit different than the sub I was on. Using the Removu K1. Well, if I'm allowed up in the conning tower, I think probably not. Oh, halfway up. I'm allowed halfway. on board. USS COD, Cleveland, Ohio. Rigged for red, control room. Continuing aft, must be radio. Remember this from mess cranking on my sub. Another access hatch to the continuing aft. Should be cruise berth. Or head, as we call it. Washing machine. Shower. And sinks. Continuing out. Engine room. engines. Four diesel engines on this pup. Access hatch.
Hey Jacob, can you pick this up?
Baby's a stick shift. Check it out. Well, your boat probably was too.
Mm-hmm. Looks like maneuvering.
You're on candid camera.
So the red lights down here were to help your eyes when you up on top of this dark cap?
Absolutely. And also, the whole boat was rigged for red at night when you're on the surface. Because it helps with the men. It gives them a sense of day-night rhythm. And then in the daytime, the entire boat was rigged for white light. I mean, there ain't no windows anywhere. No portholes, no screen doors, no way to look out, see if it's sunny or dark. I mean, you could look at your watch and see what time it is.
Continuing in. Not seeing what's going on out there. Must be after torpedo room. More berthing. More berthing on top of the torpedoes. Torpedo. And after torpedo tubes. At the point, Lake Erie. Anybody else think it looks like a poop ground? Just saying. Very windy, so I don't know if this dead cat over my microphone's working, but it's a good test for it. Cleveland, Ohio. Trying out this new gadget, Removu K1. First Energy Stadium, Cleveland. Big ship. At the point, Cleveland.
How do you do it? Is it getting your...